Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. And I am planning to give C++ best practices classes at several upcoming conferences around the world, and you should check those out if you have the opportunity. There will be links in the video description below, specifically Monday, March 31st, 2025 at ACCU Bristol, C++ best practices. I'm planning to be at C++ on C, June 26th and 27th in Folkestone. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains, and I wanted to let you know that I do personally use CLion in my work. I find the refactoring tools to be particularly valuable. The safe delete feature has saved me a ton of time when I've been doing refactoring on large projects. I can get analysis of my compile time checks and see when something is wrong or fails to compile right here in my IDE. So be sure to check out the links in the video description for a discount code and more information about how you can check out CLion. This is an issue that a student brought up to me, and it is not something that I had given a lot of time thinking about before. I dug into it because of the student's question, and this now is something that is going to become a best practice in my book. What you see here is four different builds that each have -03, so we expect a good level of inlining. At 01, we expect a good level of inlining. If we look at this code right here that is compiled with 03 and GCC 14.2, we can see that main is actually making a call to value, and getValue is making a call to value, and then value is simply returning that value. These are very straightforward, simple, very small functions that should have been trivially inlineable, and they weren't inlined. Why were they not inlined? They were not inlined because this code was compiled with -fpick. Fpick enables position-independent code. Effectively, we are signaling to the compiler that we are planning to build a shared object of some type. This is a .so on Linux, a .dylib on Mac OS, a .dll on Windows. This is the default if you're building some sort of shared library of some sort. It seems that in the case when you're building a shared object, all of these publicly visible symbols have to be actual calls to those symbols so that the user of the library could swap them out with different implementations, I guess. It seems a little suspect to me, but that is what GCC is doing. Now, this version has the symbols visible again. The reason why is in this version, we have enabled this feature called no semantic interposition. So semantic interposition, and that is the ability to swap out these functions, is by default in GCC when you enable fpick. Looking over here at Clang, we see this has the opposite behavior, which makes me question if Clang is actually breaking the standard in some way. If I compile with fpick, I still get this inlining down here in the bottom example, unless I explicitly say I want semantic interposition and then Clang out of lines these functions. Well, I started looking into this a little bit more, and I had considered for a while suggesting that you should default to using visibility equals hidden. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to enable this -f visibility equals hidden. What we have done is tell the compiler that by default, these functions are not to be visible from outside the DLL. This gives us a much cleaner API and interface. We have less concerns about the users of our library trying to use functions that we did not intend for them to use. And then some of this might go away with modules and such as well. This, by the way, is the default behavior in Visual Studio. In Visual Studio, if I am compiling a DLL, only the things that I explicitly export are visible from outside that DLL. If I want to actually make something visible in GCC, then I have to tell the compiler that is my intention. I am going to do that by explicitly marking the visibility of this function as default. I'm not actually calling get value anywhere here, so I should have done this with the value function. And now we can see that this function gets out of line. So let's modify main so that it actually calls getValue instead of value. And what we can see is that getValue gets inlined into main. GetValue still has an out of line call to value. That's basically exactly what we expected it to do. This is great. This is what we asked it to do, and we can get the best of both worlds. So you might be wondering what the actual specific impact is on your code if you turn on default visibility. First of all, if you are already a cross-platform developer and used to dealing with this from the Visual Studio perspective, then this is basically a no-op. Just go ahead and go turn on visibility equals hidden. You'll have to tweak your macros that export library functions into your DLL just slightly. This is literally a two-line change for me. Which brings me to the notion of what is the impact and what did I actually test with. I have a large open source project that I have been involved with for many years. So I went and I tested this specific thing with that library. And this is what I found. Our performance test ran about 6% faster. About 1.6% less memory usage. That's not very significant, but I feel like 6% performance improvement for free sounds like something that many people would want to use. About 6% smaller binary. This makes sense because I'm getting get a lot more functions in line that don't necessarily have to be emitted at all. And about 7.4% fewer branches, which again makes perfect sense because if I don't have to call a function, then I don't have to do that branch. If you don't currently do this, there's a couple of tips that you need to know. The first is that CMake has a visibility preset or visibility setting that you can set for targets. You can set this as a compile option. This is the global way of doing this, but you should be able to change it per target. If I say visibility equals hidden, then it'll do the right thing for the right compiler with the right platform. Now, when you go to use that library later, you're going to get missing symbols. To address that, again, if you're using CMake, you can use the generate export header feature. This gives you these helpful macros that automatically expand to the correct thing for Visual Studio versus GCC versus Clang versus GCC on Windows, etc. There's an overlap of things that you need to do here, but it's pretty straightforward. And then you just go and you mark the exports that you actually care about from this library. You have to be careful to do this with exceptions. You basically just have to do it for everything that you want users to be able to use. Exceptions is just one of those things. So go and do this. I just got confirmation from one of the developers on this team with the test that they ran. They're seeing some performance improvement, not as much as I saw. I specifically ran the performance test, and it looks like they ran the entire test suite. But you might also expect possibly faster builds and links, depending on what you're doing right now. Certainly, if you're already in a cross-platform environment, just go do this. It's zero effort, and you will expect perhaps some improvement. Otherwise, go report what happens and comment on this video as quickly as you can. Although, if you're not doing this at all right now, it's going to be much slower than quickly. But still, I think you should go do this. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe. Hope you learned something new, and I'll see you at one of my upcoming workshops.